What if you could build a full web app without writing a single line of code? When I worked at Microsoft as a product manager, I helped design the start pages for Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. Now, I didn't code those pages myself. Instead, I wrote detailed specs and handed them off to developers, and they brought the vision to life. That was the beauty of having a dev team. But what if you have an idea and no dev team? That's where Hostinger Horizons comes in. You simply describe what you want, and AI takes care of the heavy lifting. No coding needed. It's like having your own personal software engineer on standby. In this video, I'll show you how I used nothing but just a few prompts and my imagination to build a working web app from scratch. And the results were honestly kind of amazing. Best of all, you can try it entirely for free. Let's dive in. First, head to the following website. Right here in the center of the screen, let's click on Start for Free, and then you'll need to set up an account. Again, you don't have to provide any payment information, and you can test this out entirely for free. Once you finish signing in, you'll land here on the main screen, and right in the center, you'll find a text field where you could type in your prompt describing the web app that you would like to create. Right over here, you can also attach image files. For example, let's say you'd like to include a logo as part of your web app. You can do that right here. Next to that, you can also dictate your prompt just by using your voice. Right down below, you'll also see how many messages you have left. With a free account, you get 5 messages per day, and this limit resets daily. This means that you can interact with the AI 5 times every single day to help build your web app. Now, keep in mind, if you upgrade, you'll get a higher message limit. Also, with a free account, you can just set up 1 project, so use it carefully. Now, I want to start simple, just to show you what's possible with Hostinger Horizons. I'd like to build just a simple tic-tac-toe game. Type in your prompt, and once you do that, let's send it to the AI by clicking here. And now it's the fun part. We can watch AI build the tic-tac-toe game. It's now all done creating it. Over on the left-hand side, we can see all the different steps that it walked through to bring this to life. If we click on this dropdown, we can also see all of the different associated files. Over on the right-hand side, we have our tic-tac-toe game board, and we can now play a game. I've always heard it's best to start in the center, so I'll place the X right here in the middle. I'll place an O. Let's put an X right up there. Let's put an O here, and it looks like X is going to win the game. I'll place that right here. Whoa, look at that. The score looks like it's out of control. Now, I know I won the game, but not by that much. So let's click on Reset Game, and it looks like that stops it. Now, something's not coded quite right for this score. The good news is, this is just like working with a software developer. You can give feedback on the game and then continue refining and enhancing it. So over here in this prompt field, I can now give another prompt. The score doesn't seem to be working. For the score, can you keep track of how many wins X has and how many wins O has? Let's send that through. Up above, it looks like it made several improvements to the game. It updated the scoring system, and right over here, it looks like it even added a reset scores button, which is a nice touch. I can't really blame the AI for not getting the scoring right at first, since I never specified how matches should be scored. Generally, the more detailed your prompt is, the better the result you'll get. Alternatively, you can take an iterative approach where you keep refining your prompts until the output over here matches what you're looking for. Let's now try playing another game of tic-tac-toe. I'll start in the center. I'll place my X. Let's place an O. Let's place another X, an O, and let's win the game with an X. And look at that. The scoring is now working exactly how we expect it to. As you start interacting with your web app, you'll probably start noticing different ways that you can improve it. As an example, player X just won the game, but it'd be nice if there was some type of visual indicator as to how X won the game. Maybe we could highlight the row, or the column, or in this case, the diagonal. The good news is we have a software engineer that we can give this feedback to, or in this case, Horizons. Over on the left-hand side in the prompt field, let me type in when a player wins, highlight the row, column, or diagonal, and let's send that through. It looks like it now made some additional improvements. So let's test it out. X's turn first, we'll place there, O's turn, and let's place X here, O's turn, and we'll place X right up here. Beautiful, look at that. It highlights all the different squares that resulted in the win for X. Very nice. We can keep refining this app. Maybe you'd like to add an AI opponent, or maybe you want to change the color scheme. Again, you can do all of that simply by describing what you want. No coding needed. And this is really just the beginning. You could also add things like user authentication. You could store data. You could even connect to third-party APIs. Just explain what you need, and Horizons will guide you through the rest. Now, let's take a look at some of the other features on this page. In the top right-hand corner, we can open a preview in a new tab. Over here, we could view it in mobile. That way, you can see what it'll look like on your phone. Here, we'll go back to desktop. And here, you could also toggle between full screen mode. And here, we have the AI over on the left-hand side. Now, let's take things up a notch. Click on the Hostinger Horizons logo, and then start a new project. On my cookie website, kevincookiecompany.com, I've always wanted to add a little game to keep visitors coming back again and again. Something like a business simulation. Think of the classic lemonade stand game, but instead with cookies. Back on the main screen, here in the text field, I'll paste in my prompt. And as you can see, this one is a lot more detailed than the last one. In fact, I worked with ChatGPT to put this together, and you can find the full prompt in the video description. I thought through all of the key mechanics, like the pricing, demand, weather, and the marketing, and I wrote it as if I were creating a detailed spec for a dev team. One thing I've learned, the more specific you are, the closer the output will align with your vision. I'd also like to include the Kevin Cookie Company logo as part of this business simulation game. I'll click on the file upload icon, and there's a logo. I'll click on that, and I can see it right here. This is now all set, so let's have it build this out. Let's send it through. It's now generated the game, and it actually really closely matches what I had in mind. Right over here, I could set the cookie price for the day. Let's go right in the middle at maybe $3. Let's bake, let's say 400 cookies, and for a marketing budget, let's go with maybe $200. Now right up on top, I see how much available money I have and also what the weather will be. And right down below, I could start the day. So let's click on start, and then we could see the profit by day. Now, a few things, it looks like it did not incorporate the logo, and it would also be nice to know what the price will be as I configure all of these different settings. So right down here, let's see if we could give some additional feedback. Please include the logo and also show the cost. Let's see if it can make those updates. Over on the right-hand side, it's now added information about the cost, which is great, but it looks like it just included a generic photo of cookies. To be fair, I didn't specify that it should be the logo that I uploaded previously. So let's see if I could clear that up. Please include the logo file at the top of the UX, and let's attach that logo file again, and let's send that. Over on the right-hand side, we can now see that it's included the logo as part of this web app. I also went through and I made a few additional tweaks. For example, I updated this text to say business simulation game, and I also set it so the day doesn't actually start until you click this button. Now, I think this web app is in a really good place, and I'd like to publish it. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on the publish button. And just like that, the app is now live. You don't have to worry about domains, hosting, or deployment pipelines. Hostinger handles all of that for you. Also, if you run into any questions, you can click on this help menu up here, and they have 24/7 support with a real human behind it. If you'd like to try the Kevin Cookie Company business simulation game, feel free to navigate to this website that you see right here. I've also included a link in the description down below. Let's click on view site, and here we can see this beautiful game. Feel free to play the game and see what your final profit is. I got $3,530. Let's see if you could beat it. Let me know in the comments. Although we published this web app using Hostinger, you can also export it to work on it elsewhere. In the top left-hand corner, let's click on this dropdown, and here you have the option to export your project. When you click on that, that'll download a zip file that contains all of the different components of this project. To publish your app, you'll need a paid plan. Hostinger offers a few different options, starting at $9.99 per month, and with it, you get 50 messages per month. All the way on the high end, you have the Hustler plan, which gives you up to 500 AI messages per month. Hosting is included for the first month, at which point you'll need to pay for hosting as well. There is no long-term commitment, and you could also cancel at any time. If you decide to purchase, make sure to use coupon code KevinStratvert at checkout, and that'll give you an additional 10% off. And that's how I built a full cookie business simulator without writing a single line of code. Hostinger Horizons did the baking. I just brought the recipe. If you've got an idea for a web app, now's your chance to bring it to life. Try it out, and if you play the simulator, post your high score in the comments below. I want to see who's the ultimate cookie mogul. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one.